Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. No, I don't like that one. So pop an ember. Hello, good evening, welcome back to Dark Souls 3. So, as you saw at the very tail end of the last video, when I was grinding for the last tiny little bit of souls I needed, I decided to come shoot the corpse out of the tree here and get its item. It's throwing knives, it's nothing great. But I did stumble across something else that was great. When I killed this big scary mage enemy here, it's goofy because I saved quit and reloaded and stuff, so her body's in a weird spot right now, but she fell and I was like, oh, you left an item, and I came over here and I picked up the item, and it was actually an item on like one of these corpses that's burning at the base of the tree. I'm assuming that's where it came from. I'm assuming an enemy's not just going to randomly drop Estus shards every now and then. But yeah, we got another Estus shard, so I missed out on a super early Estus shard that I could have gotten, and yeah, so there's that. That's a thing. That's how my day's going. No idea what just exploded. Not gonna deal with it. We're getting out of here. Oh, this place is creepy with the noises and everything. The bodies that kind of just like sway a little bit on their own, and it's pretty great. It's pretty great, but in a pretty horrible way. Try jumping. Why would you even do that? Why would you even say that? There's our archer friend up there, like, chained to the top of the tower. Again, try jumping. No, I'm gonna say no. I'm gonna say no to that. Alright, so all of my goofing around aside, let us return to Firelink.
Welcome, husband. Very well then, taken.
We're gonna level up. We're gonna go appoint in strength.
Farewell, me.
So that's 30. We can now do this. Aha! I prepared myself.
Tis what?
And we will reinforce Estus.
Pretty, be careful.
We've got 9. Our weight is at like 60% or something, so nowhere near as nimble as I want to be, even with the much, much lighter armor, much, much lighter shield. Got a big old hammer, though. Interesting. So when it's two-handed, it swings like the Zweihander, where it kind of zigzags back and forth. Bam. 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 Strong attack with two hands is the jump. Oh, well, it's a jump if you charge it. Yeah. What do we got one-handed? So, more vertical. I may turn on the manual attack aiming. This makes it like Dark Souls 2, where even when you're locked on, you can aim your giant heavy weapons elsewhere, kind of like lead enemies or accidentally attack in the wrong direction, as I was wont to do in that game. I don't know. We're going to see what it's like with it off. Now, heavy attack is just a big old smashy smash. Oh, and you can follow it up with another one, so you can combo those. That's kind of cool. This is gonna be fun. I am excited. What is your durability? Lots. And it inflicts frost. And yes, this is a much, much better weapon, even only at +1, than our battle axe +3. 213 attack, 279 attack. So it's the best thing ever. Let's go hit something. Before we go hit things, let's start buying things. Uh, I don't know if that's a ring that I'm going to want. The first time you get hit, you take less damage. I don't know. I'm going to buy an ember. We're going to slowly stock up on those just to make sure that we always have enough. And I know they're cheaper from the other guy, but I'm also worried about like losing souls when I die, because I'm inevitably going to die here. Especially with this new weapon. So, Cleansing Chapel. I think we got to go deal with, Infinite Zombie Town. Oh, I gotta stretch. I've been sitting in this chair recording these videos for quite a while now. Oh, you're all back. I like that that phantom was doing the same thing, rolling through all the chairs. I'm gonna leave that one chair. Oh. I'm gonna leave that one chair. He can serve as a warning to the others. Make sure they know who did this. Alright. Ice hammer. What's the running charge attack like? Good. It's good. It's pretty good. I am gonna drop down. We're gonna try to get that Titanite lizard that decided not to respawn last time, I think. Miss. There we go. So yeah, I gotta remember the two-handed attacks are more horizontal than the other ones. Still didn't kill that guy in one hit. That just surprises me. Okay, we'll see how effective this is against these things. Or not. Did he see me? He did. Hello. Gosh, you're fast. I really think poise is a thing that I need to deal with if we're going to be using this weapon. Okay, before we go deal with the Titanite bug, running smash. It is kind of overhanded. Enough, maybe. What's the two-handed running smash? You're the same. Okay, good. We'll use that. Hey, buddy. What's going on? You remember me? I remember you. And now you're dead. Cool. I'm satisfied. Oh, it's gonna be so good. I can't wait to smash something to death with that. So, that was this little side journey taken care of. Just cleaning up shop from last time. Let's refill our Estus before we carry on. Make sure they're always diving downhill. Good to know. We learned a thing. We're gonna one-hand it here. Oh, what was that? It was not the attack I was expecting to do. Yeah, it's still gonna take some getting used to. It's odd being back with a weapon that has such a huge wind-up time. I say being back with it because these are the weapons I inevitably end up using in Dark Souls 1 and 2. I don't need to go this way, we need to go the other way. I'm gonna miss. Let's try that again. There we go. can kill him in one shot, though, which is fantastic. I think that might be where we want to go. I think it might be the intelligent way to approach it from this side. But where is the fun in that? Oh no. Okay, good. So we know how to deal with the bleed effect, right? Because of the torch. So we got that. I don't know if I even was able to hit the transforming ones. I guess there is a down. We could try down. Let's try down. Sure. I'll try down. I think I've tried down before. No? I would love to find whatever's making this happen and get it to stop. Oh, down there is, that's where we got the bell vine and those things. Yeah, we've been down there before. I don't know about this place. You guys are super creepy. That one's already transformed. Remember that they have, like, the worst grab attack ever. But it just... I think they're just, like, mostly putting bleed on us. And even then, it looks like it didn't happen. Oh, you are sturdy. Okay, that's fine. Nope, don't transform. I don't know if you're the one that transforms, but either way, don't. Yeah, you're like about to puke or something. I don't know. Alright, we'll go back. We'll go this way. I think this is ultimately where we need to go. I think there's just a variety of routes reaching this area. There's an item over on the roof far corner there. Just, you're not gonna stop. Oh my gosh, there's so many of you, and that one has a thing coming out of his gut. Arrows. Oh my gosh, is our archer friend gonna shoot at some of these? Why is he not shooting at some of these? His arrows are here. Oh, I would love it if he would help us out. That would be so good. So we're gonna miss. Hello, you have like twin daggers. Oh, doctor! Stagger the crap out of you, though. Doesn't look like Frostbite does much of anything at all to regular enemies. It must be more of a PvP thing, or just bad luck using against these zombies here? I don't know. Creepy enemy designs. Okay, I think we do want to go down there ultimately. Just to go explore, get items, hopefully not be shot by arrows. But let's see what else is up here first. There's something up there. A titanite shard. That's fine. I like getting those. Pretty satisfied with this weapon, at least for now, but, you know. More shards means we can upgrade and try other things. No. No, wait. Rated bad? Oh, I can't. I rated it good. Dang it! I always swap those up. Curse, ward, great shield. It'd be cool if I had the capacity to wield a great shield right now, but those things are heavy. This hammer is heavy. There was a down somewhere, wasn't there? Oh, there's up on this side, too. I think this is where we need to go. This seems right. Yeah, it seems creepy, but it seems right. These are like the things you're fighting in the forest, with the wings popping out of them. Oh, wow, so many creepy enemies. Couple of rusted coins, that's pretty cool. Eventually I'm gonna find an enemy that has an item I want, and that those rusted coins are gonna come in handy. But until I know what that is, not gonna worry about it too much. I'm worried that you're gonna, like, explode. Oh, and you have a flaming archer friend over there. We'll deal with you in a moment. This is where I wanted to go. Camera. There's my archer friend. Thanks, buddy. I'm assuming you're not gonna shoot me. Is that a bad assumption to make? Air powder. Oh, hello, you transformed. Yeah, this area is very Bloodborne. Which is fine, Bloodborne's a great game. Oh, and a bone shard. Oh, my Estus. We can make it stronger. Oh, hello. I am enjoying this immensely. You gonna transform? Nope, because you're dead. Here, soul of an unknown traveler. Okay. Feeling much better about things right now. Something horrible probably awaits us inside here. That. You were just caught fighting the wrong thing here. Oh, and you have a fat roll, too. Oh, I'm sorry, buddy. Alright. Let's see what's gonna happen over here. What are you throwing at me? Are those like Lloyd's talismans? Am I not allowed to heal right now? Yes, he disabled my Estus flasks. Interesting. Cool tactic for enemies to use. I actually really like that. Oh, I knocked your friend off too. That's great. Okay, so it looks like we can just hop down onto that and go there, there, over that roof. So that's all stuff that we can do. Let's just open these doors here and hope that it's not a boss fight first. Oh, you do not open from the side. Okay, well, That makes this even easier. I don't know why I went around. So we do actually need to go this way. That's kind of cool. Also kind of terrifying being on the roofs like this. Grave enemy, right, and you have a cool symbol for your thing again. Oh. And go straight up that way. You hiding anything clever back here? Just yourself? Just yourself. That's fine. Please, no archers. Please, no archers. Having a very Anne Orlando moment. Don't understand what all these are for. These, like, spikes? Nails? Something? Okay. Please don't kill yourself. Light yourself on fire. I said please don't. Hello. Ooh, you got a big sword again. Oh, there's a couple of you with big swords here. And you're dead. Oh, two hits. That's fine. I can hit you twice. That's fine. Oh, hello. I do kind of like that there are so many areas with enemies hanging over the edges like that. It doesn't make sense from, like, any logical perspective. Like, why would they do that? Other than to make my life miserable. But it is just fun that that keeps happening. Okay, having my Anne Orlando moment return. Bunch of you archers. Not a fan of this. Not a fan of how many of you I'm gonna have to fight at the same time. Oh! Okay. I don't know how his shot missed me. It went right over my head, though. Oh, this is great to have a real weapon. Oh my gosh, the game is so much better. I'm gonna die because of hubris. I'm jumping, but pointless ahead. Yeah, so either we can't make that jump, or we can. So there's messages there, but it doesn't look like it goes anywhere. So I'm not gonna bother. Oh. One of the chanters. I have not tried fighting them yet with the big old beefy weapon. Oh, and I see you. You're dangling. Oh, there's two of you. I was expecting one. I was not expecting two. Well done, game. Well done. Red bug pellets. Oh, I guess the increased fire resistance might not be a bad idea with all of the fire archers that I've been dealing with. Okay! That did not work. I regret my decision. Oh, you can move very quickly. You can try to cleanse this bastard's curse, but it's not gonna happen. I say nay to your cleansing fire. Oh no! Okay. Oh, you almost got me with that one, though. Really. We had to deal with our carrying capacity and our weight and all of that stuff. Stamina. Stamina's becoming an issue. It's always an issue with this build, but. You know. I'm acknowledging it right now. Even though I'm gonna complain about it for the rest of forever. Undead Hunter Charm. Oh, I was hoping for something cool. I was really hoping for something cooler than that. That's a bummer. Huh, there's like corpses down there. Is that me? Have I been down there? Or is that just from the things I've killed up here falling down below? You have different armor. And you got a big old weapon. Oh, you're fast.
Oh, poorly timed dodge. I had him. Oh, I didn't have him.
I might need to also get health, maybe. I don't know. Bummer. Oh, we lost a bunch of health because I'm not kindled anymore. My Dark Moon Blades thing were a way of blue. Okay, I also am looking really creepy and hollow. So that's a thing. My Covenant symbol is also creepy and hollowed, which I don't like. We're at hollowing 15. I don't know what that is or what's making it go up or how high it can go. Weren't we just at like 12 or something? I don't know what's happening anymore. I don't understand. So yeah, there's a whole other set of mechanics that's happening and I don't understand it. Oh man, we gotta go so far to get those souls back. I'm going to end the video here. It's gonna be on the shorter side today, which I mean like a normal length video. And yeah, thank you for joining me. May the grace of the Twilight Dragon be with you.